Are your remote workers sharing iOS devices to be able to do their job? How do you make sure that every worker is enabled with just the right tools to keep them focused and productive in their respective roles? Did you know that sharing devices can save you significant amounts of money while keeping your mobile operations nimble and efficient? Shared devices is a feature of SOTI MobiControl that can provide a solution to problems such as these. Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm a marketer here at SOTI. I'd like to show you how you can set up your shared iOS devices using SOTI MobiControl to empower your remote workforce, increase the return on investment in your mobile device fleet, and improve your business-critical operations. Let's dive right in. Firstly, it's important to note that the shared device feature is supported on Android, iOS, and a number of other platforms with a device agent of 13.7.0 or later. To get started with sharing iOS devices, you need to make sure that your Active Directory is pre-configured by your administrator. This will be executed through your LDAP, Azure AD, or IDP connections. Please note, shared devices are based on a user that belongs to a group who needs to log into the device, so it's vital that you pre-configure the Active Directory before moving on to any further steps in this process. Once confirmed, it's time to move forward with the main process of setting up shared devices in your organization. You will need to create your device groups. If you haven't already done this, or don't know how to, you should check out our video entitled, How to Manage Device Groups. You can follow the steps in this video to organize your device groups to capitalize on shared device functionality. At this point, you can apply any rules, settings, or configurations that you would like to be enabled on the main device group or its nested device groups. Now, it's time to start configuring. On the left-hand side of the screen, in the Devices view, select the device group where you want to apply Shared Device and open its group information panel. Select the desired device group that you would like to enforce a login on. This will allow you to see the More button, a green circle with three dots on the right-hand side of the device group name. Clicking on the More button will bring up the information menu. Here, you will find additional options of which you should choose the Advanced Configurations. In the Advanced Configurations menu, select Apple from the Device Type drop-down list and click on the Shared Device Configuration that you would like to set up sharing. This will bring up the Shared Device Configuration pop-up box. The Shared Device Configuration allows you to select which user groups are authorized to log in on the device. Let's quickly run through this page and understand what all these functions do. At the top here, we see Apply Changes to All Child Groups and Devices. Select this toggle in order to cascade settings specified here to all nested devices and device groups. Next, we see the toggle option for Enable Shared Device Configuration. In order to continue configuring your shared device, you will need to enable this. We'll also pinpoint this a little further in our scenario. Further down the page, we see three more toggle options. First is the toggle option for Relocate Device Back to the Home Device Group on Logout. Enable this option to send the device back to its original group once the device user logs out. Settings and configurations specific to the destination group will be removed, and instead, the settings and configurations of the home group will reapply. Secondly, we see the toggle option for Clear Managed Application Data When User Logs Out. Enable this option to delete all data from applications installed by SOTI MobiControl when a device user logs out of shared device mode. Please note, email account data is always cleared, regardless of whether this option is selected or not. Finally, you have the toggle option for Disable Device Passcode When User Logs Out. Enable this option to clear the passcode from the device once the device user logs out. Please note, this option is only supported on iOS devices or Samsung devices running Android 7.0 or later. Now that you've got a breakdown of what each function on this page does, let's move forward with our scenario. In order to continue configuring your shared device, select the Enable Shared Device toggle and begin assigning different user groups that will be sharing this device. To assign the user group, click on the green circle button with the plus sign. A set of available tools, applications, and access levels will automatically be applied according to their login credentials. After assigning the desired user group to the device, the next step is assigning specific users from that user group, as in our case scenario, the warehouse manager and associate. When a manager logs in, we are relocating the device to the manager device group. And likewise, when an associate logs in, we are relocating the device to the associate device group. Make sure to check the option Relocate Device back to the home device group on logout in order to reset your settings between each use, and also to reset the user back to the login page. Finally, once you have configured your shared device settings and are happy with your new setup, just click the Save button to save your settings and apply them to your devices. It's as easy as that. Now that we've tackled this step, let's see how you can deploy the MobiControl login app to your devices. To deploy the MobiControl login app to your iOS devices, there are a number of steps that you will need to follow. Let's take a look. First, you need to navigate to the rules, where you will select the Apple icon at the top of the screen. Next, right-click on the Application Catalog rule and select Create an Application Catalog rule. Why do we need to create an Application Catalog rule? Well, in our scenario, we will use a SOTI MobiControl login app and put that app in single app mode so that it is the first screen a user sees when they pick up their shared device. Let's move forward with this process. Once you've clicked on Create an Application Catalog rule, you will now need to name your Application Catalog rule and click Next. Here, you will click the Add drop-down menu and select App Store Applications, which is the appropriate choice in our scenario, based on the type of device enrollment you have. Here, you can choose your region. Once you have chosen your region, search MobiControl Login and choose the matching app populated. If you are using the VPP option, toggle on Enable Volume Purchase Program to enable this feature. Here, you will click on the Advanced option, and this will take you to the Add Edit Application Catalog Entry Setup box. Click the drop-down menu and select either Mandatory or Suggested. In our scenario, we chose Mandatory because this means the application will install automatically. Selecting Suggested means that the user will have the ability to choose whether or not to install this application. To add your application, click OK, and now your application catalog rule has been created. Finally, to finish deploying the rule, click Next. Here, you can choose your targeted device group. Click Next and then Finish. And now you have deployed the MobiControl login app to your devices. What if you want to lock the SOTI MobiControl app to a shared device though? Let me show you how. First, navigate to the top menu bar. Here, under Configurations, click Profiles. Then, at the top right-hand side of your screen, click the New Profile button, indicated by a green plus icon to begin creating your new profile. From the Apple drop-down menu, select iOS. Next, select the Configuration tab and choose Single App Mode. We see a number of functions available here. An admin user can modify the app setting options as shown in the video to suit their organizational needs. For this example, you will enter your SOTI MobiControl login. Finally, click Save and then save and assign to your device group. Here, you can navigate through your devices to find your appropriate device group. Once you have selected your desired device group, click Assign. And that's it! You've successfully locked SOTI MobiControl app to a shared device. Now, let's see this in action. Here's my demo device login screen. As you can see, this device is currently locked down with the SOTI MobiControl shared login application. To begin our scenario, we initiate the remote control session with the shared device that we just configured and log in as the warehouse associate. We immediately see that this device is in associate mode and that they only have access to specific applications and features that are designated for that specific device group. Once they log out, the device is ready to be used by a different user and has been relocated to the warehouse device group. When you log out, the device is moved back to the original folder as we have specified, and it only has the MobiControl login app in single app mode. Now, let's log in as the warehouse manager on the same device. As you can see, the device is automatically configured according to the manager device group setting and ready to be used without any additional setup from the user. And there you have it. You have now learned how to share iOS devices, deploy the MobiControl login app to devices, and lock the MobiControl login app to a shared device. If you find our content valuable, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you get the latest updates and stay informed and productive. To learn more about how the SOTI One platform reduces the cost, complexity, and downtime of your business-critical mobile and IoT operations, visit www.soti.net.